Welcome to the top. It's your boy Big Country. Today we're going to watch this Mexican cartels are arming themselves with. We don't know yet. We're going to see. Let's watch it.
Play War Thunder, the next-gen military online action game now. All new ray tracing, realistic clouds, lighting, and weather, as well as explosion and gunfire effects.
Mexico is on pace for another year of record violence. In the first 6 months of 2020, there were 17,439 murders, up almost 2% from the same time last year. Helping to fuel that uptick in violence is the Jalisco New Generation Cartel, or CJNG.
Tú ya sabes con quién traes la bronca, para que sepas.
Don't fuck with them. They will fuck you up, okay? Hold on. Don't fuck with us, okay? We will fuck you up, okay? All right? Now, I respect the cartel. No disrespect. Yeah.
Aquí seguimos buscándote y no quitaremos el dedo del renglón.
The CGNG leader is known as El Mencho. In the past few years, his cartel has grown from this ragtag group of gunmen in pickup trucks into this powerful paramilitary force with high-powered weapons and arms known as El Mencho. In the past few years, his cartel has grown from this ragtag group of gunmen in pickup trucks into this powerful paramilitary force with high-powered weapons and armored vehicles. In June, gunmen allegedly hired by El Mencho tried to assassinate Mexico City's police chief.
La seguridad del funcionario repelió la agresión, resultando dos escoltas muertos, lográndose neutralizar a uno de los agresores.
And in July, footage emerged of that CGNG convoy. These gunmen call themselves the Elite Group and pledge allegiance to El Mencho. In both the convoy and the Mexico City attack, the cartel's firepower was on display. They're armed with assault rifles with grenade launchers attached to the barrel, heavy machine guns, and also this gun. This is a 50 caliber sniper rifle. It's a powerful weapon that the CGNG loves to show off. Other cartels use it too. 50 caliber bullets are huge. They can kill from over a mile away, punch through armor, and even take down helicopters. These guns are outlawed in Mexico, but legal in most of the US. And there's evidence that border states with loose gun laws like Texas or Arizona are supplying them to the cartels.
I think a lot of people are surprised when they learn that, when they see that, when they see a weapon that can fire a mile and a half being sold without any kind of control at a gun show, and that how easy that is to get to organizations that are causing so much havoc in Mexico and in further south as well, in Central America.
And there's no way to track the guns after they're purchased. Some of them get smuggled across the border. Over the past few years, at least 70% of all guns seized in Mexico came from the United States. The Mexican army recovered 5 get smuggled across the border. Over the past few years, at least 70% of all guns seized in Mexico came from the United States. The Mexican army recovered 500.
I hope you guys are taking notes because we're going to take a quiz after this, okay, guys? So pull out your pens and papers and jot down notes because we're taking a quiz after this one, baby.
154 50 caliber rifles from 2010 to 2018. And all but one of those were traced back to the United States.
If you or I or any legal buyer wanted to get a 50 caliber Barrett rifle, you could purchase one from a gun dealer in 47 states. Or if it were on sale at a gun show, you could buy it. It would be totally unregulated. It would not require a background check. It would not require any other kind of review. You could bring it home with you that day. You could then pass it over the border yourself, or it would be totally unregulated.
And all but one of those were traced back to the United States.
If you or I or any legal buyer wanted to get a 50 caliber Barrett rifle, you could purchase one from a gun dealer in 47 states. Or if it were on sale at a gun show, you could buy it. It would be totally unregulated. It would not require a background check. It would not require any other kind of review. You could bring it home with you that day. You could then pass it over the border yourself, or you could sell it to someone else at a profit, and that person could bring it over the border. It's very easy to get items like that over the border because most of the enforcement at the border is focused on people and things coming from south to north instead of north to south.
American guns going south isn't a new phenomenon. It's been happening for years, and U.S. law enforcement has sometimes made the situation worse. From 2009 to 2011, the ATF allowed nearly 2,000 firearms worth $1.5 million to be purchased in order to track the buyers and sellers who they believed were connected to Mexican drug cartels. The ATF lost track of the guns, and hundreds were later recovered at crime scenes in the U.S. and Mexico. Two of those weapons were found near the scene of a murdered Border Patrol agent in 2010, and in 2016, a 50-caliber rifle from that ATF operation was found in a hideout used by El Chapo. American gun sellers have said for years that the smuggling isn't their fault, but experts say common-sense gun laws could help stem the flow of guns from America to cartels in Mexico.
I think the most important measure that the U.S. federal government as well as state governments can take is to ban the civilian possession and sale of assault weapons in 50 caliber rifles. These have no real legitimate use in civil society except the illegitimate use of killing people.
But even with the violence rising south of the border, and with mass shootings still happening regularly in the U.S., it seems unlikely that Congress will take action on sniper rifles or any other type of gun anytime soon.
All right, guys, thanks for watching. Leave any comments what you learned. Peace. See you on the next one.